you guys are awesome.
Here.
Hi. Oh no!
I have a present for you.
Third place is gone.
Bye.
Rosie, I'll see you in season 3. I like the sword better.
Bye! Bye.
To either play to those advancements and try to collect them or not. What will happen at the end of the season is what we did at the end of season 2. We still will give a reward in season 4 for whoever had the most advancements, which is what's underneath me. So, I'm just going to leave the game tick, I think, frozen while we do this, but Trash Boat, you were third place, which did not get a prize. So sorry, I'm very sorry about that. Oh, he hangs his head. But if you remember, the three of you, yourself, Just Rosie, and Baldbeard, all actually made at least one of the categories of the advancements complete, meaning you were able to get all of them in one of your shops. And there was some discussion about that. So because you did that, Trash Boat, this one down here to my right, the lowest one, is yours, including the Shulker.
Ooh.
Oh,
no, don't break that. The game sticks are still. Can you get into it?
Ooh, yeah, I got into it though.
Can you tell the audience what it is?
Sweet berries and two ender chests.
Yes.
Ooh,
so
nice.
I realize you need more than one ender chest to move stuff around if you want to take something from one place to another. So I thought, yeah, why not give you two for that? Don't break them. You don't have silk touch just yet. So that's the kind of trickiness, I guess, to it this early on in the game. Second place was Just Rosie with over 800 or something like that.
826.
And you also get the same prize that Trash Boat got because you also had a shop. So what do you
got? Oh my gosh. Okay, so I have torches and golden carrots and 4 cakes, 2 ender chests, a diamond pickaxe, and a beacon.
Meet the players. Dune Peaches. Baldbeard 007. Jade Melodica, DSC Chrissy, Trashboat 091, Just Rosie, Wolf Buttercup, Baboon 1098, and Sammy Terry 241. This is the Peaches SMP.
And with that, it is ready, set, go. The first few hours of the server, the voice chat was popping off. Everyone was so excited to get started, and it was very chatty. So I've gone ahead and muted the game sound for just a little bit while we start our first travels. We headed down the hill and to the southeast. We might have to make a few stops along the way, but that's okay because we know where we want to call home. But would this really be the start of Minecraft season if we didn't punch a tree? Now I spy with my little eye a village. Let's get a boat made and head over there. I have definitely played this game before. I know how to make a crafting table, or at least I should at this point. But it looks like I was struggling. You can see over on the right-hand side of the screen, the advancements are crazy right now. early game, we were getting a ton of advancements because we have the Blazing Caves pack on. So here we started going through the village, we gathered a bed, grabbed some of the wheat, and we looked for some chests with some goodies in it. I knew that there had to be a chest in this one, and we found it. Now look at that apple. It's a funny looking apple, isn't it? Because it's actually a peach. Wolf Buttercup did some custom pack making and turned all of our apples into peaches for the Peaches SMP. Now, I knew with this village being so close to spawn that it would not be mine forever. It was about this moment that Doom Peaches said, "Oh hey, I found a village." And I knew that he was headed here. So we took that as our cue to get going, and we were off. We had to make a quick pit stop. Along the way, we found a broken nether portal down at the bottom of the ocean. We had to check out that chest to see if there were any more goodies. Now here you can see that the golden apple is still textured as a golden apple. Wolf Buttercup and Dune Peaches are working on making the golden apple and enchanted golden apple look like a peach, like our normal apples do. We gathered up all the iron, the bell, the fire charge and everything, and we got going because we have a village to get to. We traveled by foot, and we even traveled by horse to get to the place we would eventually call home.
Okay, so what are the numbers in the tab menu if they're not achievements this year?
Chat menu, those are deaths.
Oh.
Which is why Wolf Buttercup has one.
Nice.
As I hang my head in shame.
Do the slide whistle.
Here on the Peaches SMP, we had a friendly little bet going around on who would be the first to die in the new season. We had an entry fee of 1 diamond, and winner takes all. Here are the bets. Trashboat bet on Dune Peaches. Baboon bet on Rosie. I bet on Jade. Wolfie bet on Wolfie. She was quite honest with herself. Chrissy bet on Baldbeard. Dune bet on Chrissy. And Jade bet on Chrissy. Wolfie was the first to die. She was following me down a big hill at the beginning and took a bit of a tumble. So congrats to Wolfie on winning 6 diamonds. At least there was one good thing that came out of your first death.
I have 6 signs.
Okay. This will maybe work.
Okay.
Give me one.
Oh.
There we go.
So if we...
Right here. Now if you put the water right there.
Cute.
Okay, if you place it right there, that should be far enough.
Like that?
Yeah.
I place it on the sign of water or no?
No.
Right here.
Sorry.
There you go.
Okay, one's already spawned.
Thinking water bucket clutch this?
Go ahead and try.
Did it!
I'm proud of you.
You weren't gonna put it back.
No, I was, I promise.
Hi again, Rosie here. I promise I was not trying to kill Trash Boat in that moment. I did not know that he was that close behind me and that he would be following me down the hole. It was just luck that I had happened to put that water back.
We did it.
It works.
Hey, guess what I did. Okay, but I helped.
What's that?
So right under my village was a skeleton spawner, like really close to surface. So we made a skeleton farm.
Sweet.
And I helped. I designed it. I didn't even follow a video. Look at me playing the game.
We had a Minecraft.
So it has been almost a week of having the server. Today is Friday when I'm recording this, and we opened the server last Sunday. Where are we now? What do we have done? First off, we went from 0 advancements to 216. We are currently battling with Baboon for third place. If we take a look around here, our village is a little empty. The only villager we have left is this guy in here, and he is a zombie villager. I had logged on, it was probably Monday afternoon, Tuesday afternoon, and all of my villagers were dead except that guy and the two that I had moved down to our farm, which I'll go show you after we sleep. So let's go grab our horse. We are still trying to think of what we want to name our horse. I had kind of had the idea of going with different video game names, so Zelda is the first one that I thought of for naming this horse, but I'm open to suggestions. So this looks completely different than what it started with. And we are oh so lucky that we had already moved these two guys down here before all of my villagers turned into zombies. So we had built a villager breeder over here out of the way of everything. So this is our little villager breeder, and we actually had to turn it off because if we look down here, holy moly, we are full. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, probably 10 villagers ready to be moved. We have started getting our villagers some jobs. The first villagers we got set up were some librarians because I want to sell books this season. So we've got a Fortune 3, a fire aspect, a quick charge, and a name tag guy. This guy is now standing in his boat. He was just sitting in it before. He sells Unbreaking 2. Not the best, but it was one of the first books I rolled. This guy is selling Mending, Feather Falling, Flame, and Piercing. This guy has Infinity for 5 emeralds, Efficiency 3, some glass. Silk Touch, Feather Falling 4, Fire Aspect, and another name tag. (Clears villager has fire protection. And we haven't gotten anything else out of him. This guy has aqua affinity. And this one has sweeping edge and bane of arthropods. Now, I was about halfway through these guys when I realized that just trading paper for emeralds was not the move. It was not going very efficiently. So, we got a toolsmith so I could start to trade some iron for emeralds and get some enchanted tools and such. We also got a armorer, which we've been working on, leveling up so eventually we can trade our iron. Look at that. There we go. Hi, Trashboat.
Hey.
How's it going?
Good.
What you doing here?
I need bones.
Ah. And then you wanted to come be in the video?
Well, that wasn't really my goal, but the portal is right there.
It is right there. Hey, did you know that I'm beating you in advancements right now? Anyway, then we decided to get a Fletcher to trade some sticks. And we decided to get three more. And over here, we have our animal farms. I started with one cow crusher. And honestly, just took the cow crusher design and modified it for each of the animals. So if you haven't seen a cow crusher before, it's exactly what it sounds like. It uses entity cramming, so you breed them. And then the drops go down into this chest. Same here. Breed them, they go down to the chest. Here I have some sheep, so what I've been doing is I've been shearing them. And then breeding them. And there isn't a grass block for them to eat, so they won't regrow their wool. But I found that the ones that are sheared tend to die, and then I get their wool and their meat. This one was kind of tricky because pigs do not have the same hitbox as sheep and cows do. And so I had to modify this a little bit. They kept trying to get out. Same with my chickens over here. Chickens are very, very small, and so they were coming out of it. And honestly, I haven't been breeding the chickens very much. I just have a double chest full of eggs. So as you can see, we have gotten a good start on the Peaches SMP this season. We have lots of plans, and I hope that we can get started on them soon. But for now, this is where I leave you. Thanks for watching. If you liked it, don't forget to like and subscribe, and stick around because I have a special announcement. I would like to announce that I will be participating in St. Jude Play Live during the months of April and May. This is our fourth year participating in St. Jude Play Live, and currently our lifetime total is at $960, which means we're only $40 away from having raised $1,000 for St. Jude Children's Research Hospital in 4 years. If you would like more information or would like to donate yourself, you can find the link to my Tiltify campaign in the description. I've got some fun plans up my sleeve with some of the Peaches SMP members that will happen both on YouTube and over on my Twitch channel. And with that, I shall see you next time.